in this illustration, we'll discuss about a disc colliding symmetrically to two other discs. Here the figure shows three identical discs with the disc B and C placed on a smooth horizontal plane, and another disc A is moving symmetrically, it's the two disc and stops. Here we are required to find the coefficient of restitution between these discs. So, if we draw the situation at the time of collision, here you can see if these are the two discs B and C placed in contact, and another ball A comes and strikes symmetrically, then we can see their centers will form an equilateral triangle as all sides of this triangle are equal. And at the point of collision, the impulses will be acting between ball A and B and A and C. So, after collision, as initially B and C were at rest, these would be moving with the velocity V and V in the direction of impulse. And A was coming with the speed U, and these angles are all theta, and value of theta we can write as 30 degree. Theta is the angle which the initial velocity of ball A makes with the line of impact on both of these balls. So, here we can write by conservation of momentum, in this situation we can write initial momentum of ball A was mu, and finally ball A comes to rest. So, the horizontal momentum of these two balls can be given by mv cos 30 and mv cos 30. So, this will be twice of mv cos 30 degree. Here the value of v we are getting is u by root 3. And if we calculate the coefficient of restitution, then coefficient of restitution, we know it is calculated along the line of impact, the ratio of separation velocity to approach velocity. So, the value of E along the line of impact we can write, the separation velocity between A and B is V divided by the approach velocity was U cos 30 degree. So, we substitute the values, V is U by root 3 divided by, it is U cos 30, that means it is U multiplied by root 3 by 2. So, here U gets cancelled out and the value we are getting is 2 by 3. That is the result of this problem.